Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Charlie Sylvia with Cruise Lines International Association. Thank you for being on today's call. We've got a terrific call in store for you today, folks. We have the Scenic Group in the house and a wonderful presentation by Scott Moore, Regional Sales Manager, Mid-Atlantic and Northeast. But first, let's do a little housekeeping, shall we? We've got a lot of agents that have enrolled or registered for this webinar, so we're going to give people a chance to log on. We don't want anyone to miss the valuable content. We're going to go about 30, 35 minutes with the presentation, and then we'll have time for about 10, 15 minutes worth of your questions. So please, at any time that a question comes to you, please enter it into the questions field of the GoToWebinar panel. And at the end, we will pose these questions to Scott. Also, if you have an opportunity to sell a cruise, please sell that cruise. In other words, this webinar is being recorded and it will live in perpetuity on CLIA's YouTube channel, which is called at CLIA Global. The handle is at CLIA, C-L-I-A, Global. You can find this recording there. So without further ado, let me introduce our esteemed presenter today. You know, Scott Moore has returned to his roots in the travel industry as regional sales manager for the Mid-Atlantic and Northeast for Scenic Luxury Cruises and Tours and Emerald Waterways. He spent 20 years with the Walt Disney Company, with the last 15 being in the corporate sector. And Scott's prior experience included Walt Disney Travel Company, Disney Cruise Lines, and Royal Caribbean Cruise Line. Now that shows you how far he goes back, because now it's called Royal Caribbean International, as we all know, and Continental and Eastern Airlines. And Scott was a travel agency leader, so he understands the retail side of the industry. This is really a unique perspective to have someone on both sides of the equation. Scott earned his CTC in 1995, and he continues his quest for learning, which now includes the amazing wonder of river cruising. Scott Moore, welcome to today's CLIA webinar, sir.
Thank you, Charlie. Oh my goodness, you made me sound really, I won't say old, I'll just say experienced. How about that?
That sounds great to me.
Well, thank you for everyone for taking your time out of your today to join me today. We're just gonna run through some things about the Scenic Group. I hope some of you are familiar with it, but I would imagine maybe all of you are not, or to the extent that we'll go through. So we'll kind of get started. The Scenic Group has actually been around for, this slide says 30 years, but actually 32 years. It started by a gentleman by the name of Glenn Mahoney. You see his picture there. And he was the son, his father got a resort on the Australian coast and said, son, figure out a way to get people out to my new resort. And that's how he started. So Scenic actually operates over 800 escorted departures on the likes of Top Tours, that deluxe luxury level, in 66 countries. Now, we don't sell those in the U.S., but we've been a land operator for quite a long time. So I'll kind of talk about that as we go into the riverside. So I'll go with our newest product out there, which is the Scenic Eclipse, which is the world's first discovery yacht, and it will come into play this year. So we'll talk just quickly about that. Emerald Waterways, which was our contemporary brand that was rolled out in 2014. We have currently have three ships in 2017, two in 15, and two in 14. So you can see it's a new brand. Think of it as a more of a boutique river cruise. And these are, we call it Emerald Exceptional Value. So all the airport transfers included, of course, your meals, complimentary wine and beer with lunch and dinner. You can do a drink package for 20 euros a day. There's a shore excursion included almost every day. Your complimentary bikes on board, listing devices. We have Emerald Plus, which are some culturally based shore experiences. Emerald Active, so we have hiking and biking and canoeing and yoga and all those type of things. And we'll talk about the River Cruise Guarantee. And then of all tips and gratuities, both shoreside and shipboard are included. So that's one of the things that definitely separates Emerald from our competitive set of Viking, Avalon, and Ama. Then we have Scenic Luxury Cruises and Tours, which came into play in 2009. One of the things that the Scenic Group has that's very unique is that we have a river cruising guarantee. And what that is if there is issues with high or low water, if there's lock issues or, you know, anything like that, and we are unable to operate the itinerary for more than 24 hours like it's intended to do, then your client would get a monetary proration back to them, however they pay for the cruise. It's important to note it's not a future cruise credit. It actually takes care of it right then. But of course, if there that issue happens, we're certainly going to be taken care of while they're on board. So think about the River Cruise Guarantee. It doesn't take the place of insurance. It's just a little extra assurance. Another thing that's different with the Scenic Group is that we own and operate our own vessels on the Douro River, which is in Portugal, which are purpose-built ships for that river. It's kind of a narrow river, long valley. We're able to offer longer cruises. We have our own docking facilities and so forth. So that's unique for us. So why a river cruise? So the one thing that I will tell you that when I went on my first river cruise last summer was it's really about the cultural immersion within the country. So an ocean cruise, especially in Europe or Southeast Asia where we operate, it's going to touch the outside, where a river cruise is going to go right through the heart of the countryside. And again, with river cruise, especially with Scenic, we'll talk about it's truly and fully all-inclusive. The Scenic Group, we've gotten several awards in the last few years with Cruise Critic, Magellan Awards, and so forth. So we're very proud of those. So let's talk about where Scenic sails. So this is a great map that's in our brochure for your clients that may not understand kind of how the rivers are in Europe. I get a lot of questions all the time about can we take a river cruise in Italy? Unfortunately, there's not rivers in Italy that will be able to support this type of river cruising. But you can see here from Amsterdam all the way down to the Black Sea is the Rhine, the Main, and the Danube River. That's the traditional shipping commercial route in Europe for thousands of years. And what I find fascinating is that it wasn't until 1992 that a portion of the Rhine Canal and the Main Canal was finished so that you could go that entire distance. We also have three rivers in France, two in Southeast Asia, and one in Russia. So Scenic, we call them signature inclusions. We'll talk about this, the spaceship. A river ship can only be so long, 433 feet long, and four decks tall if they're going to go on the Rhine, the Main, and the Danube River. And it's really about how many guests you put on board. We have some of the largest suites aboard. We have five dining options. We have butler service. And then our tour product, going back to our experience on the tour side, Scenic Enrich and Scenic Free Choice and TaylorMade. So we'll talk about that as well. So truly all-inclusive. So with us, again, we call it the wallet-free zone. The only thing that's additional is if you have a massage or you have a salon treatment. Everything else from dining to tours to beverages to entertainment to bikes to internet, all of that is included. And then we're going to talk about what we do on shore coming up here. So the Scenic spaceships are purposely built for the areas that we sail. We have eight on the Rhine, the Main, and the Danube. We have three in France, one on Douro in Portugal, one in Russia, and then two in Southeast Asia for a total of 15 vessels. All of our ships are purpose-built and are owned by the Scenic Company. Okay, on the tour side, we have what we call Scenic Free Choice. So that's your kind of your normal shore experience. So these are just some different examples. And you could have up to, you know, two or up to four different options during a stop. This is in Budapest, the Budapest City Tour. This is the Spanish Riding School in Vienna. This is the Amsterdam Boat Canal, which is lovely. And then this is the, then we go into Scenic Enrich. And Scenic Enrich are the specialized experiences that nobody else does. So this was the Best of the Sound of Music and Salzburg show. I happened to go able to attend this. And you go up in the mountains of Salzburg, you're looking down over the city, and you go into a beautiful, it's almost like a sort of a rustic barn that fancy weddings would be in, and you have your lunch, and you have horse beer and wine, and then you have a show, which is all Songs from the Sound of Music. And if you look at the front, the lady in the front, of course, her name is Maria, not Julie Andrews, but Maria. And there's also Austrian folk songs and instruments that are done as well. This is one that was in Paris Lichtenstein. This is in Vienna. I got to experience this as well. Paris Lichtenstein has the second largest private art collection in the world. You come in, you do a lovely reception with champagne, and you go into the music room that you see here on the slide, and the beautiful orchestra, the dancers, the singers, it's a quite lovely evening. This is one that's in France. And this is our newest one that's in France as well, the Cine Rouge Cabaret Show. And this is Sundowner. So we do this on one time during a particular cruise, and it's a toast to the sundown. This is on the Danube, so this is actually my picture. And this is the viewpoint that we were looking down over the Danube as the sun was going down. And we do the toast. So here's me doing the toast. This is a selfie, so it's not that great of a picture, but it was actually absolutely beautiful. And again, a very private event just for scenic guests. Another thing that Scenic has on board is the TaylorMade, which is kind of like a big iPhone device that you wear, you can wear around your neck. And it has over 720 points of interest. It can be used on board the ship, and it can also be used at port. So the idea is you have this on board, you take the e-bikes, you go out, press the button, you're in the city, and you're like, I want to go on this tour and see these museums or these Costco buildings, and it takes you there. Also, which I found this very interesting, is you're on board, you're sailing down the Danube River, and you see this beautiful home or castle, and you go, gosh, I wonder what that is. You go get your TaylorMade, you push the button, it knows exactly where you are, and it tells you what you're looking at. So it's a real, very handy. Okay, let's talk real quickly about the onboard experience on board Scenic. So this is the reception area. The ships are going to be very contemporary, clean lines, very modern look to them. This is the Panorama Lounge area, which is where your main activity would be, your port talks and so forth. So if you look at the top, I was pointing to this picture. If you look at the top and you see all the spirits, again, everything on Scenic is all included. So there are no, as you go into the Caribbean sometimes and all inclusive, and they say, yeah, we're all inclusive, but the top shelf ones are additional costs. You don't have that on board Scenic. This is another viewpoint from it as well, looking the other direction. These look like some happy folks on board in the lounge. So the other thing that we have is the all-day dining in the River Cafe. So this is where you could get a casual breakfast or casual lunch. There's all kinds of sweets and so forth that you can take throughout the day. So this is a nice added feature. Now, this is the Crystal Dining Room. So dining on board is all open seating. There's tables of, 2 to 8. So if you want to have a quiet romantic dinner for two, you can certainly do that. And then you meet some people on a tour, and you're like, oh, these sound like really fun people. We'll have dinner with them. And then you have dinner with them, and you find out that they're not really as fun as you thought. So you go back to your table, too. So that's fine. But this is the Crystal Dining Room. A lot of regional wines are included, depending on what region that you're going to be in. And then also Portobello's or Le Bourg in France. So this is kind of like a specialty restaurant on an ocean cruise, except there's no bill for it. And this you would be included or invited to by your butler. You would be assigned an evening to go to that, and this is a different menu. If you're on the Diamond Deck, you do have Table La Rue, which is a 6-course meal with wine, so it's much more of an intimate dining experience, and you're guided through the selections as well. So Scenic is really about inclusion, everything's included, and innovation. What's new and different? So the Scenic Culinary, this is the first on river cruise for 2018, and it's on our ships in France. It's the onboard cooking school. So we actually took suites out of the ship, so we have less guests so that we could put these cooking schools in there as well. So this is not only do you shop with the chef, but you come back and you you cook your dinner. This is unique too, called a slot room. Don't know if any of you have been on a slot room, but it's a unique spa experience on board the ships, the two in France. In 2019, we're putting these on all of our ships. So because it was very, very popular, but this is supposed to be make you feel really good, very numerous health and benefits there in the salt room. So Cindy pioneered the concept of glassed-in balcony. So in 2009, when the ship was built, what we decided to do is to take that space and bring it inside your suite, and you have a glass drop window that comes down, and you can bring it halfway down, or you can bring it just a little bit, just want a little bit of an air. But that way you can enjoy the beauty, you can feel the fresh air, but you have that space inside of your suite as well. So onboard accommodation, so we have the queen size slumber beds, which are very comfortable. We have the Egyptian top linen, and we have the pillow menu, which really confused me when I went on board. I didn't know which pillow to pick. And then the walking sticks, and you have your Mac mini system as well. So, of course, a complimentary fully stocked bar. This is the Apple Entertainment Center. So this is what's really neat about this is that you can click on the reports that you're going to or the stop and take a look and learn about the history. And then what I did, when you come back, you re-look at the where you've been and you really have a good feel for it. So, and of course it has movies and all those types of things that you would typically have as well. These are just some of the categories. This is the standard stateroom. It's located on the bottom deck. This is your balcony room. So this is the majority of the suites on board Scenic, 205 to 225 square feet. This is the junior suite. So you're moving up, got a little more space there, 250 square feet. And then you move up to the Royal, which is 360 to 510. Available as well. And then the Royal Owner Suite. So you can see the suites are very spacious, they're very modern, and again has that very clean line touch to it. This is what the bathrooms are like. You can take a look there. These are the products, lots of things that we use on board. And then of course every category you'll have a butler service. So that they can take care of any type of dining arrangements, laundry. We have laundry concierge service. So everybody, whatever category you're in, gets laundry service. The higher category you're in, the more laundry service or the more dirty clothes you can take with you. Onboard entertainment. There's a lot of regional entertainment that's brought on based on where your port is. We have the wellness center on board where you can, again, have a massage. Now, those are additional costs. And then we have the fitness center. As well. The pool area is on top of Scenic, the Vitality Pool. That's a nice picture there. And then we have the e-bikes. I told you that we were all truly all inclusive. You don't even have to pedal on Scenic. You just push the button and the e-bike works. You can do some independent traveling like you see here. Scenic, again, we're on the Rhine, the main Danube, Moselle, Rhone, Doro and the Volga River. So those are our rivers that we are going to. So these are just some of the itineraries, the main ones. So this is the Jewels of Europe, which is really Amsterdam to Budapest. So this is like the whole enchilada of where most people go. Then you can shorten that and do a Rhine highlight from Amsterdam to Switzerland. This is going into Basel to Amsterdam and then going on the Moselle River. A little bit different. And then this is the south of France, which is Paris to Nice, which is a beautiful itinerary. There's also shorter versions of this. And then the Normandy and the Gems, this is 11 days. So we're actually, because our ship is specifically designed for this, we can get closest to the Normandy beaches than any of our competitors. This is Bordeaux, of course, the wine and food region of France. And this is the Douro River, which is in Portugal as well. And then the Christmas markets become very, very popular. So this is the new Christmas markets on the Rhine and some new Christmas markets on the Danube. And then Gems of the Danube. So this is the kind of one of the main routes, especially first-time river cruisers take, Nuremberg to Budapest. And there's your itinerary. You can also do, it's very popular, do a three-day Prague extension, either before or before. This is the map that shows you where you're going to go from Nuremberg down to Rheinsberg, the Passau, and then on into Austria. So you get four countries plus the Czech Republic if you do the extension. You can see over to the right, it'll tell you there's one enriched experience, 15 free choices, and one sundown. So in our brochure, it's going to tell you exactly what you're going to get on that particular itinerary. So day one, you would get on a Nuremberg. This is kind of what it looks like. This is what the free choice activities would be on day two and day three. Now, on day four, you go to Passau, and it tells you what your free choice is as well, which is quite beautiful. And then in Melk to Dernstein, you have the sundowners, scenic sundowners, the view of the Wachau Valley. So the picture that I showed you of me, that's where it was. So if you kind of look up to the right of that church steeple, it was up in there. Quite nice. And then this is very interesting. You can do a Melk to Dernstein, the 20-mile bike ride, which is quite beautiful, on the e-bikes. And so here's me, once again. Here's a picture after I finished it, 23 miles, which was a lot of fun. It was a very neat experience and not hard at all, especially with the e-bikes. You also have wine tasting there at a winery. Then when you get into Vienna, oh my gosh, Vienna is beautiful. You dock in the heart of the city. You can go to the museum on a city tour. You can go down to Slovakia, Bratislava, or you can go, this is the picture of the Schoenberg Palace, which is absolutely gorgeous. And then day seven, you go to Budapest. So Budapest is amazing. This is the Parliament building that you always see the pictures, especially beautiful at night when they're all lit up. Quite something. And then I love this slide. There's the Buddha side and the pest side. So it tells you which is which there. There's lots of bridges that cross. And this is Hero Square in Budapest, which is a very neat place to go to as well. So we're going to move from the Gems of the Danube to Southeast Asia cruising. So we're on the Mekong and the Atawada River. We have two purpose-built ships for that. This is the Spirit, which is on the Mekong. This is the 11-day itinerary that you would start out in Vietnam, and then you would end up at Siem Reap. And when you end up in Siem Reap, the highlight of that is Angkor Wat, which I was fortunate enough to go to a few years ago, and it's quite an amazing, amazing destination. This is the sun deck on board the ship, so you can kind of give you a little feel of what it looks like. This is the Crystal Dining Room. Again, this ship is 68 guests, so much smaller. This is one of the categories for the suites. This is another one. This is the Royal on the back side. And then when you go to the Scenic Aurora, which is on the Atawada River, this is a neat itinerary too. Again, Southeast Asia cruises typically be for people that have done Europe and they want to do something different. Again, this is what the ship looks like. You can see the theme of the ships having the very modern and very clean lines throughout. Again, what the category would look like. And then we'll put them with the nice balcony on the backside. So now we'll kind of move on to the Scenic Eclipse, which again, that's kind of where I started. This is our brand new product, the world's first discovery yacht. So we're very excited about this. This is an actual picture of it being floated out of the shipyard. Actually, this was taken on January 31st, kind of the first time it had gone out into the water. So it's very much different like that. So today than it did then, but I think it's a fun picture to show. This is what it's going to look like when it's completed, 100% veranda balcony. There are 8 spacious lounges and bars, the pool, the spa sanctuary, and the pool terraces, both an indoor and outdoor pool, 4 outdoor terraces. And it, will have actually 10 dining experiences and for only 228 guests. I'll say that again, 228 guests and 10 dining experiences. In the polar regions, it will actually only have 200 guests. So its inaugural season starts out in August 31st. It will leave Athens and go through the Med there and then come over to Miami and do a 10-day round trip Cuba, and then back to Miami, down to Cartagena, down to South America, to the Antarctic, where it will do about 10 sailings, and then back to Europe, and then up to the Arctic. So we're very excited because back in February, we announced the second ship that's going to be announced. So it's going to have a twin, the Scenic Eclipse 2, the Scenic Eclipse fleet. And this will be the itineraries for 2019-2020. So you basically can see that it's going to go, you know, all across the world. The difference is some of the new things for 2020 will be the Russian White Sea, the Russian Arctic. It will do Greenland, go through the Northwest Passage, and it will actually come down the Canadian Maritimes, down into New York City, and then back down into the Caribbean as well. So it'll have a little bit of the U.S. East Coast. So a couple of things to tell you about this ship. This is it has custom-built Zodiac, again, with Scenic Eclipse, just like the Scenic River. There are no additional costs. Everything is included with except for two exceptions, which I'll tell you about. The custom Zodiacs, they're all included. What's lovely, too, is that the jackets that you see people have on, those will be part of the that you get, each person gets when they get on board to keep. They'll have the jacket, they'll have the boots, and they also have what they call basically it's a mudroom, but it's heated. So when you come back from an expedition like this, you'll be able to go into the room, change into your robe and slippers to go back to your room, keep your jacket if it's probably wet or cold, in the room along with your boots and so forth. So that's a very nice feature as well. Wow, it's going to have a helicopter. Not one helicopter, but two helicopters on board. Now, there will be additional costs for that. We're thinking it hasn't been set yet, but we're thinking it to be about $300 to $400 for a helicopter experience, which is a reasonable expenditure. We'll also have a seven-man submarine, so which is very unique and different, and that will be that'll be an additional, a little bit additional cost as well, about the same thing. This is the spa sanctuary on the back of the ship. It's almost 6,000 square feet. Again, that's a pretty big spa for a guest count of 228. This is the theater. We'll have your port talks. We'll have your first run movies, entertainment. You can see it's very luxurious, so there's a seat for everybody. Everybody can attend here each time. This is the main lounge. You kind of look at this, so this will be large enough for everybody to gather at one time if they choose. And these are some of the different restaurants. So this is Element. You can see there, again, very, very contemporary feel and look to it. This is the chef's table, which will be a small dining experience. This is the Japanese restaurant. Lumiere's will be the French scene as well. The Mexican bar you can see there. This is one of the sushi bars. And the yacht club. So you can kind of see the pool in the background. That will be an indoor and outdoor pool. This is the more casual place that you can have food and beverage while you're enjoying the pool in the deck area. So the suites on board, this is the brand of suite, the smallest one, which is 345 square feet. Moving up to the spa suites. Then this is another picture of those. And the Pamaranda Suites, now we're up to about 1,200 square feet. Another picture of the bathroom with the big tub. And this is the owner's penthouse suite. So this is almost 2,100 square feet. So quite lovely. And this is the back deck of it with the So the thing to think about scenic and rich, I mean scenic eclipse is that you know, we are seeing the world's first discovery yacht. It mirrors luxury with expedition. We're calling it discovery, but the ship has a polar six hull, so it's able to go into regions that other lines have not been able to do as well. So very, very small and intimate. There are some promotional things that you can do for 2019-2020, some early bird specials and so forth. Also on the scenic river, we are offering complimentary air through August based on availability for 2019. So that really makes it all inclusive. Our agent portal, so if you go on scenicusa.com and also emeraldwaterways.com, there is a part that says agent at the top, and you can go in and find out all the information. We just unveiled a new specialist course, and when you take that, you're able to get a $200 gift card when you make your first booking within 6 months. There's some comparison charts on there. There's information on your regional sales managers, whatever area that you're in. It's just a lot of, you know, there's a lot of things. We also have a tool called Express Book, which you can go and register, and that's how we know to do business with you, and you can, that's how we'll communicate with you as well. So take a look at the agent portal. Yeah, there it is, your Express Book, our online booking engine. Now this is something that's on board in our website, but it's called the River Cruise Advisor. It's a third party that puts this out, and it's a great chart. There's another one that's a little more updated. But basically, if you look down to the left, you'll see the cruise line that are prominently selling in the U.S. and North America, and you'll see what the inclusions are. So when you're selling a cruise, and you're especially taking an ocean-going cruiser and converting to river, you really have to take the time to explain to them what is included, because it's very different than what's included on an ocean cruise. So while the price point could be higher to begin with, your per day per diem is going to come out to include all of these things. So if you look across, you see scenic checks all the way across. You'll see Emerald quite a few checks as to its competitive set. So this is a great tool to utilize. So that kind of wraps it up. Kind of in a nutshell, if you were comparing scenic river cruises to a hotel, we would tell you that it's like a Ritz-Carlton and a Four Seasons without a bill at the end. If you were comparing Emerald Waterways to a hotel, we would kind of say it's like a W hotel, very modern, boutique, kind of cutting edge. And of course, the scenic eclipse, there's nothing like it yet. So we're extremely excited to launch that. So if anyone has any questions, I think I'll be happy to address those.
Sure. Thank you so much for that, Scott. We do have some questions, and people can feel free to keep typing them in as we go. I'll start with the ones that we have already. So our first question is from Warren, who would like to know if Scenic is a publicly owned company.
Warren, that's a great question, and we are not. We are privately held by the gentleman Glenn Mahoney and his wife Karen, which you saw the picture at the beginning of the slide. So we're an Australian company that operates or sells in Australia, Canada, Great Britain, and the U.S., and only in the U.S. in about the last 5 years.
Perfect. Thank you. Our next question is from Richard, who is wondering what the demographic profile of a scenic cruiser looks like.
Richard, great question. So I will tell you that typically on river cruising as a whole, the demographic's a little older than an oceanside. However, what I like to say is it's really about people that want to be culturally immersed in the destination, whether they're 40 or they're 80. You want to be active. It's not about sitting on the deck and watching the river go by. It's really about being involved in the destinations that you go on. Typically, scenic will be a little bit older, probably late 50s, early 60s and up. They're the type of person that wants everything included. They want all the decisions to make be already made, and they'll decide when they want to do it. Emerald, I think, is a little younger demographic. It's a little more active. To me, it felt like it's someone who wants to go into a destination, get an overview with the tour of the day, and then they want to go and take the bikes, or they want to go out on their own to do things to have a little more independence.
Okay, great. Our next question, also from Richard, are any of the staterooms on or below the waterline?
So on all river cruises, the bottom deck is actually halfway below the water. So if you remember seeing the window, sometimes they call them a swan window. So when you're standing up and you're looking out the window, yes, you can see the river, but it's going to be about just a little bit below that window. So it's almost like an inside stateroom on an ocean ship, because if you're docked, you know, against, or if you're going through the lock, you're not going to see anything because you're too low. But typically the bottom of the ship, your half of your room is below water.
Okay, great. Our next question is from Jeffrey, who realizes that Europe is not very handicap friendly, but what about the ship itself?
Great question. So you're right. Europe does not have the ADA laws that we have in the U.S. The ship itself is, there is elevators up to three of the decks. The elevator does not go to the sun deck, and none of the ships do because of the bridges. There are times when you can't use the sun deck. We do have a wheelchair on board, you know, but people basically have to be able to get themselves on and off the ship, because sometimes based on the water level, you could be walking down or you could be walking up. The other issue on river cruising is that sometimes you're docked next to another river cruise that you either have to go through it or up on the sun deck and down. So as long as your clients understand that it is different, that it doesn't, you know, you don't have to have, it's not law mandated access, you know, they can still enjoy that even though they maybe need a little more help on and off.
Okay, great. Our next question from Warren, does Scenic have a loyalty program?
Yes, we do. And Emerald just launched one as well. So there's four different levels, and that can be found on the website.
Perfect. Joan is wondering if there are any FAM opportunities.
Yes. So what I would recommend that you do is to get in touch with your regional sales manager. And again, you can find that on their website. And, you know, touch base and say, hey, that you'd like to learn more about Scenic and Emerald, and they'll put you on that list. So we do some throughout the year. And we'd love to get people on board. Absolutely.
Okay. Our next question is from Siobhan, who is wondering if you accommodate special diet needs like veganism and stuff like that.
Yes. So from any pretty much any type of diet, you just let your butler know, let the ship know, you know, they, you know, whether it's gluten free or whether it's vegetarian, whatever that might be, they're right there to take care of that for you.
That sounds great. Our next question is from Cindy, who is wondering if Scenic and Rich is an extra cost or if it's included in the cruise fare.
Scenic and Rich is not additional cost. There are no additional costs at all, except for a massage and a hair appointment on Scenic River.
Okay, perfect. Richard is wondering if any of the river cruises visit Poland.
I know none of our products do. I can't vouch for others. I don't really know the geographic areas of Poland. I don't know if they have rivers to be able to do that, but we do not.
Okay, good to know. Debbie is wondering what the minimum age suggested for children is and if there are any adjoining cabins.
Great question. For Scenic and Emerald, the minimum age is 12. And we do not have adjoining cabins and do not have triple or quad berth.
Okay. So Valerie is wondering your rules for smokers.
There are a couple areas on board outside on the deck area that smoking is allowed, but there's not any smoking allowed inside in any area. But there are a couple designated smoking areas.
Okay, great. And our next question, are there physicians on board?
For the river cruise, there are not. And I think that's pretty much the same with all river cruises, partly because you're not far any, you're not very far from any kind of medical facility if you need be, but there is not like an ocean cruise where you're going to have an infirmary.
Okay, great. And Mimi is wondering if you could go over the guest and stateroom quantity on the Scenic and Emerald ships.
So on Scenic, the guest count, depending on the ship, on the Rhine, the Main, the Danube, is 167 to 169 currently. In 2018 and 2019, it will be 165 because we're putting the Falklands in. And on Emerald, the guest count on the Rhine, Main, and Danube is 182. When we go into the ships in France for Scenic, it's 151 and 138. And for Emerald, it's 138. And then the ships are even smaller in Portugal.
Okay, great. And it looks like this is our last question. Siobhan is wondering which ship has the salt spa.
Say that again.
Which ship has the salt spa?
The salt room. So the two ships in France have it. And then in 2019, all of ours will have it.
Okay, great. And it looks like those are all of the questions. Again, this was recorded and it'll be posted to CLIA's YouTube channel, which is CLIA Global. And I just want to thank Scott so much for your time. And thank you so much, everyone, for joining us.
Appreciate it. Enjoy the rest of your summer. We appreciate
thank you so much. Have a good one, everyone.
Alrighty. Bye now.
Bye.